In the previous video, we have done up to implicit function, differentiation of implicit function. Further, I am continuing that differentiation of logarithmic function next. Logarithmic function. Logarithmic function. Now, for example, I'll take an example and explain you. Say I have y is equal to sin x to the power of cos x. If y is equal to sin x to the power of cos x, find dy by dx. That is derivative of y with respect to x. Find out that. Now, here, if you get a function of x in the power, then it is called as a logarithmic function. Logarithmic function. So this is given now. Y is equal to sin x to the power of cos x. This is the given problem, and we are asked to find out differentiation of y with respect to x. Now, this has to be somehow brought down. From the power, it must be brought down. The only way that can be done is if you take logarithm. So, taking log on both sides, what happens is log of y will be equal to log of sin x to the power of cos x. Now, using the power rule in logarithm, this becomes log y is equal to cos x into log of sin x. Log of sin x. Right. Now, this has two components. One is this and the other one is this. And here, you have to, if when you differentiate this, you get both product rule as well as function of a function. Both will come here. See, differentiating throughout, d by dx of log y, d by dx of log y is equal to d by dx of, this is a single term, cos x multiplied by log of sin x. Log of sin x. So now, differentiation of log y with respect to x is 1 by y. Log y differentiate, if you differentiate, you get 1 by y into dy by dx, because we are differentiating a function of y with respect to x. If it is with respect to y only, it will be 1 by y. But it is differentiation of a function of y with respect to x, so you will get dy by dx there, into dy by dx is equal to this side. This side, this is v, product rule I'll use. This is v, this is u. So it will be log of sin x, log of sin x, this is v, into d by dx of u. That is d by dx of cos x plus product rule v into du by dx into u into dv by dx. That is cos x into d by dx of log of sin x. Log of sin x. Now, this will be equal to 1 by y into dy by dx is equal to, this will be log of sin x, log of sin x multiplied by, this will be minus sin x plus, this will be cos x, d by dx of log of sin x. It is function of a function, that is d by dx of log of sin x is 1 by sin x into differentiation of sin x, that is cos x. This is what you get. Now what we want is dy by dx is equal to, this y can be sent that side, 1 by y, if it goes this side it will be this thing, minus sin x, first you write minus sin x into log of sin x, log of sin x plus, this can be written as cos square x divided by sin x. This can be further simplified, but you can leave it like that, at that you can leave it. This much if you do, that is sufficient. This will be this thing. So here you see, we will have to use product rule, function of a function, everything will get mixed up in these problems. So this is how differentiation of logarithmic functions is carried out. Next, after this, we have successive differentiation. Next is successive differentiation. Successive differentiation means differentiating more than once, maybe twice, thrice, four times, any number of times you can do it, but from your exam point of view, only it will be two times. That is, it will be asked like this. If y is equal to tan x, find d square y by dy square. That is, first you find out dy by dx, then what is the answer? Once again you differentiate it, the answer, that is called as another time, that is called as the successive differentiation, twice. Up to twice only, you will not be asked more than that. So this is called as successive differentiation. It can be done any number of times, but for you it will come only twice. So now see what happens here. So y is equal to tan x. So therefore dy by dx is equal to d by dx of tan x. We know that standard, we have given the list of standard derivatives, d by dx of tan x will be equal to secant square x. So this is dy by dx. This can also be called as, they call it as y1 also, dy by dx. Next, what is the differentiation of this? The answer that we got here is this. By differentiating this, we got this. Again, once again, you differentiate it. So d square y by dx square means d square y by, sorry, here I have written, dx square means differentiate this once again. The answer that we got must be once again differentiated. Now this will be 2 into secant x, because square 2 minus 1 will give you 1 only. So 2 secant square into d by dx of secant x. Now it is function of a function. 2 secant x, that is the differentiation of this, multiplied by differentiation of secant x. We have to use function of a function rule. Now this will be equal to, this will be equal to 2 secant x into differentiation of secant x is once again secant x tan x. So it will be, the final answer will be 2 secant square x tan x. This is d square y by dx square, or they also write it as y2. y1 is first differentiation, y2 is the second differentiation. So like this. Now this completes all the types of differentiation that is there. Now what we do is, we will do some problems. We have to work out a number of problems. As many problems as you work out, you get better and better. The more exercise you do, you become stronger and stronger. Physical exercise. The more you walk, the more you run, you become more and more strong. The mathematics is also like that. If you run fast daily practice, then you become very strong in mathematics. Now we will work out some problems. I will start them. I will take problems from the old question papers. See, in section A, each question carries 3 marks. There are 4 questions here. There are 4. Every paper, you will find 4 questions in differentiation. So 4 into 3 is 12 marks. Then in B section, you have 5 marks questions. You have 3 questions here, that is 15 marks. In section C, you have 2 questions of 6 marks each. So you will get 12 marks there. 12 plus 15, 27. 27 plus 12, 39 marks will be there here. See, I'm going backwards. November, December 2017. This is the latest paper. Section A. There are 3 problems. We'll go one paper by one paper. There are 4 problems in section A. That is problem number 3, 4, 5, 6. Problem number 3 is if y is equal to x square plus 5x, find dy by dx. 3 marks. Very simple 3 marks. So dy by dx is equal to d by dx of x square plus d by dx of 5x. First type, it's a binomial, this thing, x square. The differentiation of x square is 2x, that is 2 minus 1 becomes 1, that we need not write, plus 5 into differentiation of x with respect to x is 1, so it remains that much only. This is all that you have to do, and you get 5 marks for this. 3 marks for that. Question number 3. I made a mistake. No problem. The problem is, I have taken the problem wrongly. If y is equal to x square plus 5x into log x, find dy by dx. I forgot this. I left off this log x. Okay. Now here there are 2 functions. It's a product of 2 functions. This is one function, this is another function. So this must be solved by using product rule. So what I have to take is, take u is equal to x square plus 5x and v is equal to log x. So du by dx will be equal to differentiation of this, that is 2x plus 5. Differentiation of x square is 2x, differentiation of 5x is 5. dv by dx is d by dx of log x, that is 1 by x, standard 1 by x. So now what we want is dy by dx. This is v into du by dx plus u into dv by dx. This is the product rule. So v log x into du by dx, 2x plus 5, plus u, x square plus 5x, into dv by dx, 1 by x, or it is 2x plus 5 into log x plus x square plus 5x divided by x. This is the answer. This is dy by dx, carries 3 marks. Next, problem number 4. Problem number 4 in the same paper, same section, section A only. If problem number 4, if y is equal to 3x square minus 4x plus 5 whole to the power of 6, find dy by dx. First thing that you have to do is in what formula it comes, which form, which rule we have to use. Now this comes under function of a function, differentiation of function of a function. What we have to do here is put u or something is equal to 3x cube minus 4x plus 5. This whole thing, take it as u. Then y is equal to u to the power of 6. This I have taken that entire expression as u. So y will be equal to u to the power of 6. Now du by dx, differentiation of u with respect to x, differentiation of this will be 3 into 3, 9x square, minus differentiation of 4x is 4, and dy by du will be differentiation of this with respect to u, 6u to the power of 5. Now u is nothing but this one. So this is 3x cube minus 4x plus 5 whole to the power of 5. Here this 5 is 0, that's why I have left it. 4x is 4, 3x cube is 9x square. Now what we want is differentiation of y with respect to x. It will be equal to dy by du into du by dx. Now dy by du is this, 3x cube plus minus 4x plus 5 whole to the power of, no, this multiplied by 6 is there, 6 into this to the power of 5 multiplied by du by dx is 9x square minus 4. So this is the answer of this is the differentiation of this particular. 3 marks for that. Next, fifth one. In the same paper, same section, again for 3 marks. Find, this is fifth question, find dy by dx if x square plus y square is equal to a square. Now this comes under, differentiation of implicit function. So what we do, this given thing, this is the given equation. I'll do one thing, d by dx of differentiate throughout d by dx of y square is equal to d by dx of a square. So this will be 2x, this will be 2y into dy by dx is equal to 0, because a is a constant, a is not a variable, x, y, z, they are variables, a, b, c, etc. are constants. So now 2y into dy by dx is equal to minus 2x. This 2x I am sending that side. So dy by dx is equal to minus 2x divided by 2y. This y, these two get cancelled. So it is minus x by y. So this is for again 3 marks. Again, question number 6. If x is equal to a tan theta and y is equal to a secant theta, find dy by dx. This is another variety. This is a parametric function, problem under parametric function. Now x is a function of theta, y is also a function of theta. So what we have to do, x is equal to a tan theta. So dx by d theta we have to find out. Differentiate x with respect to theta. This will be a into secant square theta. Similarly, differentiate y with respect to theta. Dy by d theta will be a into secant theta tan theta. So this is dy by d theta, this is dx by d theta. Now what we want is dy by dx, differentiation of y with respect to x. So it will be a secant theta tan theta divided by a into secant square theta. So this a gets cancelled, one secant theta gets cancelled.